Hello guys, welcome to my channel Life on Wheel. Today we'll be cooking Patol Chingri. It is a Bengali dish. The dish is basically Parwal or pointed goat with prawns. It's a very delicious dish and I know if you try it at home, you will definitely like it. And also this dish, I like to make it such a way so that you can have it with rice and roti or chapati both. And if you like my video, then please give a thumbs up, share with your friends and subscribe to my channel. So let's start. The ingredients that you will need are, I took 500 gram of parwal. You can see how I peeled the parwal. I did not peel up the whole skin. I kept a little bit of it. This will add a little bit of crunchiness to the vegetable. Two diced potatoes. 400 gram of prawns peeled and deveined, sliced onions, chopped tomatoes, green chilies, tez patta or bay leaves, dalchini, elaichi, jeera, garam masala powder, jeera powder, red chili powder, haldi or turmeric powder, salt, garlic paste, ginger paste, ghee and oil. First add the oil to the frying pan. I prefer mustard oil for this dish. You can use any other oil of your choice. While the oil is getting hot, we'll add some salt to the parwal. Now we'll transfer all the vegetable to the frying pan and we'll cook it until it gets a golden brownish color and gets a little bit softer. Basically we are semi cooking them as of now. So we can see the brownish color on the parwal. We'll take them out and keep aside in a bowl. Next we'll add some salt to the potatoes as well and give it a good mix. Next, we'll transfer the seasoned potatoes to the frying pan and let it fry. Similar to the parwal, we will cook the potatoes till they turn golden brownish in color. The main purpose is to make them softer so that the cooking time reduces. They are cooked now, so we will take them out from the frying pan, keep aside in a bowl. While we were cooking the vegetables, we had already added some salt and turmeric powder to the prawns and kept it marinated. We'll now add the prawns to the oil and cook it slightly. Please remember one thing, the moisture from prawns comes out very easily, so we do not want to fry them very much. We'll keep it light. Because we want to keep the prawns juicy, not very crispy. So the prawns are done now. So we'll take them out from the pan and keep them aside. Just for your reference, this is how they should look after cooking. Okay, so now it's time to cook the spices. We'll first add the jeera, the bay leaves, dalchini and elaichi and give it a light stir. Now we'll add the green chilies and the onions. We'll cook the onions till it becomes golden in color. We have already cooked the onions for about 2 minutes now, so it's time we add the tomatoes to the frying pan and give it a quick stir. Now we'll add the ginger and garlic paste to the frying pan and we'll cook it for about 2 minutes more so that the smell of ginger and garlic goes away. After for about 2 minutes, we'll add in the salt. This will help the tomatoes cook faster. Now it's time we add in the dry spices. First goes in the red chili powder, then the turmeric powder, then the jeera powder. So we'll give it a nice stir, and we have to keep on stirring at this point of time to make sure the spices don't burn. Crush the tomato pieces with your spatula so that they mix well with the other spices. As oil starts separating from the spices, we add in the water. I added for about 750 ml water. Mix everything well and then we will add the fried potatoes. Cover with a lid and cook for about 10 minutes. We have added the potatoes first because it takes more time to cook if compared to parwal. After about 10 minutes, we'll add in the parwal and the prawns too. Mix well and then cover with the lid. We will now cook again for about 10 to 15 minutes. In between, I always check up once if the vegetables are okay, if they have cooked or not, if the water level is okay or not, so that the spices and the vegetables don't get stuck in the pan. The vegetables are already cooked, so we'll now just check the consistency of the gravy. It seems just fine to me. Now we'll add the ghee and the garam masala powder to finish it up. We'll just give it a light stir. Now I'm adding just a teaspoon of sugar. This is totally optional. You can definitely skip it. So finally, it's ready to be served. Once you make it at home, please let me know in the comment if you liked it or not. And in case you have any request for me, if you want me to cook something specific for you, then just let me know in the comment section as well. I'll see you next week with another video and another recipe. Till then, goodbye, take care, love you all.